Today in this lovely portrait image, I'm going to try changing the background and enhancing it with the free Snapseed app. After importing, first I'm going to try changing the background. Using the double exposure tool, I'm going to add this image of the mountains, making it bigger and placing it at the desired position. Setting the opaqueness to 100 and applying it. Now to reveal the original image, some masking work is needed. Tapping on the stacks icon on the top right, view edits, tap double exposure and brush. First with the added background image hidden. With the brush transparency set at 100, I'm gonna roughly brush out at the top to reveal it. With the brush value at 0, again brushing roughly on the subject and the foreground to disclose it. Now zooming in as much as possible and with the brush value at 100, brushing out carefully on the outer edges of the main subject to fine-tune the selection. This will take a lot of time, so fast-forwarding it. Now to get the flowery foreground selection, first gonna try carefully to reveal the flowers. Then fine-tuning it by brushing out the greens. It is certainly not easy to get the seamless edges here. With a few tricks we can get better results, which I will try later. Toggle the red mask to check if the mask is applied correctly. Next, to darken the lower part of the image in curves, I'm gonna drag the top point of the curve down and also the middle part towards right to darken the overall image. Then with masking, with the effect applied, removing the effect over the top parts of the image. Also, we'll try to darken the left part of the sky a little with the brush value at 50. Trying here to give the effect where the sunlight is coming from the right edge. Now for some selective filters. A couple to brighten the greens on the top part of the foreground. One on the faces where I will try to smoothen the skin by reducing the structure. Little brightness. And some saturation. More brightening the right part of the sky. And want to give more color to the blues in the sky. Now I'm gonna try to give some blurness to the background. Selecting the lens blur tool, changing to linear filter, moving to the bottom so that the foreground is in focus and the background more blurry, reducing the blur strength just a bit. Then with masking, removing the blur on the subject carefully by brushing out the effect. Also at the bottom on the foreground. Next, I'm gonna try to give some color to the brighter parts of the sky. With the curves, I'm gonna lift the blacks, then add a bit of yellow by dragging the blue curve towards right. Also a lot of red. Then with masking, first roughly brushing on the sky to reveal the effect, then fine-tuning it. Now to hide the uneven selection on the edges of the foreground, I'm gonna try adding a hazy effect. Again with curves, crushing the blacks, adding yellows and lot of reds. A bit different color tuning than the one we applied in the sky. With masking, applying it. To give more pop to the flowery foreground, selectively applying hot contrast preset with the curves. Just a bit on the sky too. Next, to give some color to the overall image, adding a bit of red tint in white balance. A couple of selective filters. First on the face to tone down the reddish skin tones. Also some contrast. And also more color to the brighter part of the sky. The changes after each edit. And the final result. Thanks for watching.